this poster came out, when Rosemary's poster came out, guys were in disbelief. Everyone was just like, wait, what? Are we talking about Zimbabwe money? Are we talking about UG shillings? Are we talking about TZ shillings, or is this Kenyan money? 50,000 per head, 500 USD per head, Rose. Then I think guys were sort of waiting for this confirmation from Rose Muhando to just come and say, you know what, guys, chill. This is actually 50,000 Tanzanian shillings. So yeah, she came out and she was confident without batting an eyelid. She was like, it's 50,000 Kenyan shillings per head. So that, you know, cumulatively, if we are looking at it through this other eye, it is $500. Na mewambia, kama mtaki kwenda. By the way, you know, she's like, at this point, I think Rose is like, you know what, if you don't want to help me raise money for my equipment and for the church that I plan to build, you just might as well kick rocks and suck dick. Period.
Here we go.
Sari Podcast, brewing entertainment, honey.
What's up, people? Welcome back to hashtag the Podcast. I'm Rich Lubis, my name. This is, of course, the home of entertainment commentary. Subscribe if you haven't, if you're just peeping or you're just, you know, passing by. You are most definitely welcome to brew this honey with us. Let's get insert Rose Muhando's voice. Rose Muhando, the TZ singer, gospel singer, who at some point we honestly thought this one was about to backslide. I don't know, there were even rumors claiming that Rose Muhando has now, you know, ditched gospel and she has gone back to being Muslim. Now, you see, she has come out to clarify that, excuse me, it's whether you like it or not, my concert is still taking off. So, you know, I looked at this and I was like, why did she do the same concert down there in Tanzania? And if she's to do the same thing, will she be courageous enough to tell guys that I am billing you 1 million daga shillings to be able to access and to watch me perform? Why did she pick Kenya? Why? And you know, to be really honest with you, some of these things, honestly, even said out loud, even said out like this at 50k, it honestly feels like, Rose, is there something you need to tell us, Muhando? Muhando, is her name Muhando? Yes. Madam Rose Muhando, is there something you need to tell us that maybe we know, that you know that we don't? Because this situation, this whole issue sounds very suspect. And from her confidence, do you know that confidence that is unfazed and unmatched? And someone is just like, if you don't want it, you're not forced to come here because I'm doing this. I don't know, I want to construct a church. We want to buy equipment. And then when she was asked, so where exactly is this church going to be built? She was like, we've not yet figured that logistic out. Now, guys, honestly, let's just have honest conversation. Do you think Rose Muhando, one, would be this confident if she did not know that everything that she is working towards has already been taken care of? You know, as in probably there's just somebody somewhere who is already, you know, they've already cleaned everything that they want to clean and they're just like, you see, you know what, hun? Do a concert. Tell guys Kempinski 50k per head. So, I mean, to us who are looking at it logically, we are like, who's going to pay 50k? Who? I was even having a conversation with someone and they were like, currently I'm looking for 3,000 Kenya shillings. Then the hand comes here and tells us 50k. Who is going to cough 50k to be part of that concert? Who? Let me tell you who. The people who have already been organized. This is nothing. It's nothing impromptu. They are not looking to make money from ticket sales. That is what I know and that is what I will stand by. Yes. Nimesema. Because there's no way you're going to be be this confident. Alafu, alafu, why did she take the same concert, same money? Peleka Tanzania uoneka kuna watu wataingia. And something else. Let me ask you, Kenyans. If we are to just take one of our best gospel artists, and I don't mean like this gospel wash ones. I'm talking about proper gospel artists. Those ones who sing and you feel like it has touched you up until you're like, I'm giving my life to Christ right now after listening to that music. Do you think if we are to take our best to Tanzania and tell them we are charging you 1 million Tanzanian shillings per head to come watch one of our best stellar performers put down a show, do you think they'll pay? Question. Do you think they'll pay? Do you think a Tanzanian will even pay Rose Muhando 1 milli Tanzanian shillings to just watch her perform? Do you think the Tanzanians will even be in a position to cough $500 to watch Rose Muhando performing? There is something, there's something big here that is just been, it's not really been amplified, and it's been hidden underneath this wing of I'm going to charge you $500 because it's a concert that we are holding for God and we want to buy equipment and we want to do this. And we're just like, at least tell us something realistic, man. But $500 with that level of confidence, I was just like, there is something this hand knows that the rest of us don't. So anyway, long story short, the concert is still taking off. It's going to be where it was initially supposed to go down, and entry fee is $500 per person. That's what we're going to pay, you see? So for those of you who are of the mindset of why should I pay 50, you know, and I can just watch this concert in my house, or maybe I can just play a CD and listen to Rosemary. I don't even know, you know, if her fans, like her loyal fans, can afford the 50k. So anyway, I'm sure Haita Oga, but we are yet to see. And if this thing does not backfire, I will prove my conspiracy theory that there is something that's bigger, that there is something here that is just being played, that there is someone behind Rose Muhando with the 50k thing. Omunene like this. But anyway, what do we know? So eneni, mukaji enjoy. Msaidie Rose kununua vyombo na pia msaidie Rose kueneza injili, msaidie Rose kueneza injili ya Bwana, because once you contribute, it's going to help build or construct a church.